Hey everyone, welcome to High School Dropout's Advice here. Let me ask you guys a question. Do you agree with me that electric vehicles are the future? If you said no, then this video might be not for you. But if you said yes, then let me ask you, what all electric cars have in common? Yes, they need a battery. So I'm quite surprised that most investors focus on the EV car makers, but not focusing on the suppliers. But I guess this is a good thing for us. There is just more money on the table. Today we will talk about Panasonic, and let us find out if it's a good company to invest in or not. The price to earning ratio, also called PE in short, is just at 18.51. But look at LG Chem, which is at 87.86 times the price of its earnings. This is like 70 times more. You might think this is because LG Chem is way more significant. Then let me show you this. LG Chem has overtaken Panasonic and CATL last year and got a total of 24.6% in market shares. This was a strong move, but having more than 25% market share than Panasonic should not translate to having a 70 times price to earnings. This just doesn't seem right. You might argue with me that LG Chem is also getting their revenue from petrochemicals field. So let me show you the revenue distributions. You can see that 18.9 out of 37.3 with the Korean won, which translates into like 50.6%, is coming from the sales of the EV batteries. In other words, LG Chem is making most of its revenue with EV batteries. Look at this strategy they have for the next year. They expect a sales growth of 50%. This translates to like 25% growth for the entire company. So now we can argue if an 80.86 price to earning ratio is fair or not. But knowing this company will expect to grow 25% in revenue in the next year with battery sales alone is immense. But we are talking about Panasonic, which sits there with its 18.9 prices to earning ratio, but having a 19.2% market share of EV batteries produced in the world worldwide is very off. And to simplify, and not to get too hardcore into the details, both companies are profitable in their other areas. So there should not be something holding a company down like 70 times its price to earning ratio. So let me try to explain what happened and why we see such a big difference in price to earning ratio between two companies who target the EV battery market. First, have a look at LG Chem. Look at this graph. We can roughly say it was about 3 times less in the beginning of this year. Then we got the news coming in that Tesla will use LG Chem batteries for all their Model Y. Then we got word that LG Chem is overtaking Panasonic and CATL to the leading EV battery manufacturer. Then we got rumors that Tesla is buying the battery production division of LG Chem, which puts the stock to the ratio we have today. So this is like very hyped up. So let's have a quick look at the Panasonic graph. You can see nothing moves here, and it got like a 50% dip after 2018 when it could not quite ramp up its production for Tesla. But again, keep in mind, Panasonic is still number 3 in manufacturing batteries. If we say the evaluation of LG Chem is too high and a fairer price is, let's say, at 50, then we also need to increase Panasonic to at least 40. This would translate into a more than doubling the current price to closer to 30 bucks per share for Panasonic. This was only talking about the fundamentals, why I think the evaluation is not fair for Panasonic at this current time. Now, let us touch on the business strategies and the demand of the market and see if the number 3 has a place to play. So let us end the fundamentals part right here, because this is not showing us the stock's potential. As you might know, Panasonic is a Japanese-based company that focus was on producing household electronics. As you can imagine, those are low in profits. And I got good news for you. The company is shifting away from making those products and focus more on car electronics and batteries for EV cars. The current CEO will retire this coming April, and the new CEO, Yuki Kusumi, who is currently the head of automotive, will take over. As you can see in the source right here. Luckily, Toyota, another car maker giant, is deciding to make EVs. A year ago, Toyota was focusing on just doing hybrids, and they thought hybrids are the future. But all traditional car makers are doing EVs, so Toyota has to join their game. The risk of missing out is just too significant. Like Kodak when it decides not to do digital cameras, but this is another topic. Anyway, Toyota is partnering up with Panasonic. The plant should make 500,000 batteries per year. But Toyota said that they expect to sell 5.5 million cars per year, which is insane. This means that the batteries won't be enough when we expect the EVs to be 15% of Toyota's total car sales. Maybe Toyota has another battery supplier, which they did not mention yet. But I think that Toyota got the numbers wrong here. There will be way more than 10% EV sales from their total numbers if their car is competitive enough. But let us shift back our focus on Panasonic. For Panasonic, this is just good news. This means they can build another gigafactory once Toyota realized that one gigafactory is not enough. You might know that Panasonic is working with Tesla and is currently the leading supplier for Tesla's battery. They also have a gigafactory together in Nevada. This is a smart move from Toyota to partner up with Panasonic, since Panasonic has experience with the leading EV car maker, Tesla. On the other hand, Panasonic has another strong business partner and is not only dependent on the growth of Tesla. There are some good and some bad news with the partnership with Tesla. The good news is that Tesla is continuing its partnership with Panasonic, as you can see in this source right here. Panasonic also confirms that this partnership is profitable for Panasonic, but it was expected. Otherwise, they won't build another gigafactory with Toyota and focusing on making EV batteries. But the funny thing here is that Tesla is forced to continue the partnership with Panasonic because Tesla is growing faster than it can produce those batteries on its own. It takes 1.5 to 2 years for Tesla to build a gigafactory. And with this sales growth, it's forced to stay in partnership with Panasonic. The Gigafactory is at its limit. It's producing around 35 gigawatt hours. What does it mean? This means it can produce about 466,000 batteries with 75 kilowatt hours batteries in average. And you know that the sales of Tesla for 2020 were 499,550. I used 75 kilowatt hours as the average size of battery of the Tesla batteries in all their EV models. You can see the battery sizes they use right here. The contract between Panasonic and Tesla will extend 10 years after they hit a particular milestone. But the public does not know about that milestone. It's a secret. But we know that this partnership is profitable for Panasonic, and Panasonic is having the same collaboration with Toyota. So at this point, we forgot another vital market, which is Europe. Europe is a massive market because they have plenty of car makers. Many countries decide to ban fossil fuel vehicles and internal combustion engines soon, as you can see in the Wikipedia source. I'm sure many countries will be added to this list very, very soon. So this is a big market, and I was happy that I found out that Panasonic is expanding to Europe, as you can see in this source right here. But there's one problem. Panasonic is the last big battery producer who enters the European market. There are already 15 gigafactories in development. So is Panasonic too late? I think it would have been an advantage to be early than to be too late. But will it hurt Panasonic in the long run for being late? I don't think so. Because those 15 gigafactories are not producing enough batteries. There are 280 million cars in Europe. The 15 gigafactories can only produce 7.5 million batteries a year at max capacity. And worldwide, we have 74 million vehicles selling each year. This was the sales number of 2020. So we know that a significant portion of the new cars has to be EVs very soon. And who wants to stick to old combustion engine when you know you will have problems reselling them shortly? With the shift to EV for most European countries, the 280 million cars currently in Europe have to be turned into EVs very soon. 74 million new vehicles sold in 2020 and having a capacity of 7.5 million in Europe is about 10%. This sounds maybe okay for the next 1 or 2 years, but this is nowhere enough for the 1.4 billion cars worldwide. You can see that there are so many new electric vehicles coming out, like a Mercedes, the Jaguar, GMC, Audi, Hyundai, BMW, and the Lucid Air. It's just countless. So many car makers, and many of them are coming with several models each year. So I'm not worried about the demand. There will be something for everybody. I'm concerned about something in the opposite direction. I firmly believe that the market will grow faster than they can produce batteries. So you might already see that it's useless for Panasonic to build too many gigafactories and expand too quickly when you know that lithium will be in short supply very soon. There are not enough lithium mining companies, and it takes them time to ramp up production. That's the problem we are facing. This is what I found out, as you can see right here. So we can argue if Panasonic is too defensive and too slow with ramping up production, but this might be an advantage for Panasonic when there's not enough lithium for battery production. LG Chem, on the other hand, would have a higher cost to maintain while this shortage lasts, which will cut into their profits in their future. And I also found out this news about lithium mining. They will increase their price because supply is falling and demand gets higher and higher. This means lithium will cost more and battery will become more expensive, which means EVs will become more costly. But the companies usually will become better at producing EVs or batteries, so for us, there shouldn't be too much of a change. So let me tell you what I think about Panasonic. I think the shift in business orientation is the right way to do it. Moving in an EV battery sector is correct. The demand seems bigger than the companies can handle, which means significant growth opportunities. But competition is fierce. Panasonic might look to work slower and expand slower than, for example, LG Chem and other companies, but this could be an advantage when lithium shortage becomes real. You can see that a couple of days ago, Panasonic has increased their profit forecast for strong demand mainly because of the partnership with Tesla. So I think the current valuation is not fair for Panasonic. How can it be that Panasonic only increased like about 90% in the last 5 years and Tesla is increasing 2,840%, and the price to earning ratio of LG Chem being at 85 times and Panasonic at around 18. All cars transformation into EVs is a big business, like the cars business was 100 years ago when we moved from like those horse coaches to engine-driven vehicles. With a successful shift, the new CEO and the new gigafactories, the significant demand for EVs and the change in a greener world, I'm optimistic that I will see a 500 to 1000% in return in the next 5 to 10 years. But let me also tell you that I'm not a financial advisor. Take my advice and my research as entertainment value only. I'm just a random Random Guy on YouTube. If you like my research on Panasonic and the stocks, please share and subscribe to my channel right here, where we will talk more about stocks, real estate investment, and more importantly, how to get a wealthy and healthy mindset. Thank you so much. See you in the next video. Thank you, bye. So let me show you the revenue this dude, man, only depend. Oh man, Fred is...